Welcome to the world's largest online art event. We are going to be taking you on a journey of art with Mr. Neeraj Mitra, who's a visual artist. Welcome to the curatorial art walk.
Thank you, Akshira. It's really wonderful to see, at the World Record event. And I remember when we conceptualized it, it was something really, really amazing. You know, the vision was to die for. And so when I collaborated, I really felt honored and I said, okay, let's create magic together. So congratulations to the team, congratulations to Rajesh especially, and the force behind. Of course, you have been a pillar of strength to many. We have designed it. See, when we create art, it has to reach out to the audience, the right audience. And today's effort is in that direction only. So as everybody can see that we have got this particular interesting setup, which looks like very high-end mall, which is specially created, and from the banners, hanging banners, to the help desk. So if you see all these orange points, you can go there and check out what is happening and all this in this vicinity. And then we have got many art shows. This is how the whole look and feel of the, so everywhere. And then if we go to the conference hall, we had many conferences there, which were like more than 50 panelists were there who spoke about their journey and shared about their art, their creativity and everything. Then we have got agendas where we had many different activities, game zones, and many different activities were happening at that place. And art gallery, of course, we have got more than 15 art galleries there. And IIF have, they have came forward. They said that, why don't we have your solo show? And so from quite some time, I was taking part in many, many international national exhibitions, but to have the solo, it's a very big deal. And since it's pandemic is on, and we all know that it's a little struggleful for the galleries as well as for the viewer also to visit. In that context, these we created galleries here. And if you see it, we have got, as part of the competition, we had visual art. We have got, other galleries. Akshita, if you can just go back a little bit, let me talk about the...
Yes, sorry.
Yeah, no issues. So let's go back to the, this is look and feel, the glimpses. So a teaser is here, trailer is here, but let's go back to the main, this thing. And after that, we will enter and I'll take you to the journey of my room, which I call it my room, where my queens are galloping nicely.
Yes, just give me a second.
No issues. With technology, we always get little challenged because we don't know whether we are more fast or technology is more faster. Mm-hmm. So we have got different categories here. If you can see that we have got the first one is a visual art there. We have got paintings in that. We have got digital art, photography, sketching and doodling, ceramic and pottery, creative writing. And then we have got, we are honored to have us get associated with Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy. And we exhibited their works, which were part of their annual art exhibition. And we had a panel where we had Anoop Shah, Akash Das, Ajay Suresh, Sharad Verma. And we are lucky enough to have their photographs on on display, which is really wonderful because they all are really very accomplished photographers of India. Then we have got Ramesh Pitsa, and we have got Jagmohan Bangani, Vikram Saram Sarvara, two shows which I curated earlier as well. And I'm very fond of both their works. Then we have got Hemraj, who's a very dear friend and one of the finest, India's finest abstract artist. His Reminiscence 2.0, and of course, right now, Chandrakant Chennai sir's show is also going on. I'm hosting it in my gallery, which is Gallery Artist and Art Abode, which is in Gurgaon. And we are having his show also simultaneously on this platform, which is Transparent Black, because Channe sir works only with black. Then we have got Auriculture by Ancon Mitra. His installations, you must visit this, because the way he has played with the origami, or he does art with paper, is really, really amazing. Then we have got IVS Schools of Designs. They did Art Fest, so it's their works are also here. It's like by them. And then we have got Design. Major chunk which I have, then Spirit Unlocked is also there. I'm sorry, I which is curated by Lubna Sen, who is a dear friend and working very closely with for the cause with underprivileged children too. And we did a show together where all the proceedings went to underprivileged kids. And we have got 101 Art Masters. Now this show is very special because we have got international artists who participated, though they participated in other things also. But here all together, 101 Art Masters, where you see all different kind of, very energetic art forms here, like painting, sculptures. And so this is overall view of WLOC. And as it's written there, spotlight you deserve. So I think I deserve that spotlight. And now, in the center, if you see the Flowing Equines by Neeraj Mitra and the Zards and the Kesars. Now, the Zards and the Kesars are my series. I work mainly with horses, and the Flowing Equine, which I did in the lockdown. And as I say that lockdown is, it's a blessing in disguise to many and to me as well, because I could work a lot. So, Akshita, we are ready to gallop together in my show, which is we have got more than 200 artworks there, Flowing Equines. So, and the show name is Talion's Imperia. So let me take you through how the virtual gallery looks like. So we will go back. This is the main room where you can see that this is Talion Imperia and branding the way it has been done. And it's very interesting to see that technology, which has played a very interesting part. If gallery cannot, we cannot go to the gallery, gallery can come to us. And the whole series which I did, Akshita, we can just move around to the curatorial note. And yes, so this is, you can read later also about Selene Imperia, the Zards of Passion, the Cases of Dreams, which is here. And most of the works which I have here, they are on paper. So Zards and Kesars, they are in a different room, different show which we have done. This is primarily on a acid-free paper, and I've used inks here and a gold paste. So all these works which are done in the lockdown period, I have done semi-realistic, realistic, a little bit mixture of both. And as everybody says that, whenever we create something, Akshita, we can be a little slow. And especially I would like to take you to these two works. Yeah, Akshita, where you're missing is there? Yeah, this artwork I would like to just have a close look at this.
Neeraj, we've lost you, I think. Hello? Neeraj,
I'm here only, Akshita. Just
okay.
No, I'm here only. Just have a close up the thing, and we'll talk about it.
Okay.
Just give a close up to this. Yeah, just can we go more close? We can go to the next artwork. Now this series is very close to me. I the whole I got inspired here with the Kantha stitches. So if you see, if we can go more closer, so you can see that I've tried to give the thread effect here. So when I was creating these kind of artworks, what was happening was that each night, and I used to create, sit with my different art materials at 10 o'clock at night and work till the wee hours, like till 2, 3, 4. I mean, I had lost count of my time. We can move further, Akshita. And so in the process, you know, like every day, it was a different story, different, you know, energy oozing out. Now, if you see these two artworks on my right hand side, I treated this like, again, layered, a lot of layers are there, which is done with the poster colors. And a lot of textures are there, and a lot of layers are there. If we up close, if you see it, you will be able to find, and you know, like I think it's the center one, the brown one. So this particular artwork, I was inspired by the you know, the fort and the fortresses, because I've used the main doors and the windows like this, the, you know, the way people, when they, I mean the horses, when they enter, that elan and that, you know, so those kind of things. And this is how I treated. I mean, this was a different treatment altogether. So if I have pen and ink, I have worked with paste, I've worked with you know, a lot of poster colors, inks and watercolors. And so all in Flying a Queens, most of the works which I have, they are on paper only. Okay, so if you see this particular artwork, this is again all with waterproof pens. And as I was working, it was getting more simplified, and the more design elements started creeping in and more breathing space around. And on the right hand side, if you see that again, it's on a textured paper, again inspired by, and here I wanted to show a little bit of, you know, it's a lost city kind of feel. And as you know, that if we go through the history, what we have around us is all you know, like from the ruins to and the horses have been part of our history in any civilization. They have been with us. And I somehow feel, I think I take energy from horses, and that what I try to bring it on paper. So whenever I work, so this is another day, another feel to it, and where I worked a lot of like with inks and with poster colors together. So this was fun, and a lot of reflection I wanted. This was like the abundance, the freedom, you know, the free spirited nature. So that's what I try to reflect on these artworks. Now this artwork, the black and white, if you see, it's very close to me. And probably, you know, it's like I felt that, you know, it's like the change maker is always like a king, you know, and the whole city, the whole world looks up to them for the changes. So this is exactly what my thought was when I was creating this. And then this is again part of, there are like, if you see these again, now these are again, I worked with inks and the flow of, you know, water, which did all the magic here. And compositionally, I really felt very, you know, like close. If you just go close to this, yeah. So this series when I did, not this one, the previous one which I did, I mean the ones with the pen and ink which were showing. And I must thank Akshita and team, Himanshi, Rohini, who did a wonderful job. Yeah. So this is very interesting. And like, you know, I by this time, it was like after 3-4 months of the lockdown, and by this time, I was getting more into millennialism, and my work was getting more millennialistic, and it was fun. You know, lines were getting, yeah.
Sorry to interrupt. I wanted to ask you, you know, you are primarily working with horses, And
Yeah.
you've used different mediums in terms of, you know, textured paper and paint and pen, and you know, it's a lot of fun elements that we see in this interesting Kantha work right here. I wanted to ask you, what is the reason for you to primarily choose, horses, and why have you chosen this versatility of mediums?
So first I answer that why I choose the horse. So I think it's other way around. Horses, they chose me because they wanted to have a different language. That's one thing. But on the other hand, I love the form, and that's one thing. I find the beautiful, you know, like it's rhythmic, it's never tiring, it's and it's been there in all ages, in all terrains, in all climates. Horses are everywhere, and they've been part of us. And then few childhood memories are there, profound memories, because when I used to go to sketch to railway station, we had this tonga stand. And when I had come to Delhi from Karnal, so we had these, tongas there, not this patpati or not this sharing autos or sharing rickshaws or e-rickshaws, nothing was there. Tanga was one of the thing. And somehow then, you know, you start relating to that particular incidents of your life. If you see on the right hand side, I'm sorry, can we just go back?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. So if you see these works, these are paper tearing also. This is collage and paper tearing together. So again, a very, like, one fine day, I was just sitting and working with paper. So, you know, like when you work, you never stop yourself. If you see that, this is again, I've shown, I mean, I love the process of creating. So horses was one of the reasons which I did. And then when we talk about the versatility, I think I am a versatile artist, multidisciplinary artist. And that's the way I am. I mean, my basic nature is like that I love to experiment, and I love to, dabble with different material just to challenge myself that how interesting and how different I can make things. Like, if you see that the ones which you are showing going through right now, is they are charcoals.
Right.
So, I mean, I love charcoals. So it's like the whole idea is that when you're creating something, I never stop. And material should not be the one who is, you know, like holding you. Material should not be the reason for not working. And when lockdown started, I had very less material in my studio because I was not going to my studio. Whatever I was doing, I was working from home. And initially, though, I had to take supplies of my child, and I started working it. But gradually, I never wanted to stop the, you know, time which was there, and I never wanted that I should stop somewhere and not create. So whatever material was available, I was working on it, and this is how. And then I started getting and ordering online, and you know, it's a journey with everyone. And this is how it happened. And see the outcome, like it's one show, but on each wall, if you go towards your right, just go towards your right. Sorry, my left, sorry. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. Screen sharing.
Just see this one, the black one with the blue corner one. Yeah, this one where your cursor is. If you look at this work, it took me, I was working on the empty space here rather than creating something. And then I was at the stationery shop. Then I started going out, and then I looked at it, and I found these colors, which are Japanese colors, and they work very well on black color, black paper, you know? So yeah. Another medium, another exciting thing. And I was like, I came home and I said, ki like, yes. And this stationery guy is very smart, you know. Whenever something new comes, he just tells me, ki like, yeah, I try karo. And I'm like, I don't want it. I mean, you know, that way. where he says, no, ye wala try karo, this is really good, ye achha hai, ye alag hai. So like that. And on my right, if you see it now, this is the next to it. Dry brush is there. This is all with the pen, calligraphy pens, which I worked with. Then I love to experiment with the paper. And this again, it's a texture paper. I mean, whenever I go out, I mean, now to everything is like art all the time. And whenever I go out to any stationery shop or any paper shop to buy my supplies, I mean, there are very interesting shops in this place called Khari Bavli or Chavdi Bazaar. So there are wholesalers of paper. When I go there, I mean, I feel that I just want the whole, you know, supplies, whole everything like at my place. So I pick up a lot of stuff. And this is, I know, working with the washes. Then the watercolor was one fine thing. It was happening. And if you can just go to the work, left work. Yeah, this one. Just go to this. And then you look at it closely and tell me what it is. If you can just zoom it a little bit more, if that is a possibility.
Okay, just let me try.
Just go a little close and I'll ask you, like, what do you think of this work?
No, I think this is the most I can zoom. Oh, no, I can. Right, this is very interesting, though. It looks like a zebra, but I'm not sure.
No. I do only horses, but my horses, sometimes they look like zebras. No, not that way. This is, I have used wool here. I've used embroidery here.
Oh,
this
yeah.
This is all embroidery.
Absolutely, this is all thread.
Yes, so I used all, you know, woolen thread to do it because I just, like, you know, every day I was working with paper, pen, ink, this, and I said, no, I have to do something different now. So I started creating with embroideries. So I did embroidery on paper.
That's
so a lot of stuff goes like that.
very, very.
Yeah, and if we go to the next work, yeah, this corner one, the center blue, if you see it there. No, the other one on the left hand side, if you go. Yeah. No, this is not the one which I want to talk about.
Okay.
I mean, of course, these are all different tones which I took out with poster color. Yeah, you on your left. Yeah, this work. Now, if you see this work again. Here, embroidery is there, and then I've used stencils. Now, then I did a lot of stencil work also.
Sorry. You know? Yeah.
So, this is what I'm saying, that, you know, when you are with your material, when you are with, you know, different, if your bag is full of different materials, you end up creating really all different kind of, different sort of works. So from embroidery to color wash to, you know, sketch pens to pen and inks to glowing pens to charcoals. Again, this one I did stencil, and I've got this embroidery and thread work done in this. So, and then of course the colors, and you know, this is all embroidery section, you can say that way, because
yeah.
I love playing with the dry pastels and textures, and of course embroidery was at that particular. So in nutshell, if I say that every night when I, and yeah, just go to this, close to this work.
This one?
Yeah. And look at this, what it is, you tell me now.
My God, this is so interesting.
So yeah, so this is, these are names of horses which are used in different languages. So I learned all that, Kadini, Kal, Mal, Kal, Faras, Farasi, you know, Hester, Ziggers, Zardin, Zaran, all these words are like, you know, in different country, the horses are called by these names. So this is how I started. that was really fun, you know, like I learned it, and every night when I used to sit, I used to Google that, ke Neya wala mein kya aata hai, Korean mein kaise bolte hai, Arabi mein kya bolte hai. You know, so that those are like interesting things. So I had that calligraphy I was in that zone, calligraphy zone, I was into. And if you see this work also on your right, which are there, these are again very, you know, it's tree of life kind of thing, which I did. Again, these works are very close to my heart. I just love them. I mean, बहुत मजा आया था ये काम करके.
Absolutely, they all look fabulous, Neeraj. Let me ask you, while we shift from this gallery to another, I think we've had this tour. I'm going to just enter the other gallery. Sorry about that. One second. Where do you draw your inspiration from? You know, I mean, working with horses is one thing, but the way that you represent your art is what I want to know. How do you do it? Where do you draw your inspiration from?
See, inspiration is everywhere. Like I'm talking to you right now, what I'm experiencing, the way technology, I'm not a very technology oriented person, but see what I'm doing. I think probably when I started this, no, when we started having this, you know, lockdown things, I'm like, just what is happening types. But I think I was one of the most calmer people.
Mm-hmm.
And inspiration is everywhere, you know, each and everything inspires me. A sentence, a word, you know, talking to you, interacting with anybody on the road, or when I am able to, you know, add smile on anybody's face, and when they smile back, that inspires me. A good food inspires me. A good thought inspires me. Any good book inspires me. So now the stage has come that, you know, that inspiration to draw horses, no, I don't need that inspiration. Now what we need is, we just need that, we need to work. And if I say that I paint, I draw, I create, no, it's a divine power. It's something else which makes you, you know, do things, create art. So it's like that. These are all my oil sections. And apologies about the little poor quality of the paintings, few paintings. We are going to work on that. I think, Akshita, we need to work out on it.
Absolutely.
And these are my Pharaoh series, which I did. And this was, again, this is not lockdown work. Few of them are lockdown works, but few are like I did earlier, and few I did. These are all these works are new works which I've created. And they are bigger ones. Then I was like, these are early works wherein I did a lot of realism into it. And then if you see the contrast from realistic, I just got into very, very simplistic. And, you know, it's the feminism, if you see. And this work was highly appreciated by, you know, one. It's called SPVR. It's at St. Petersburg. There is a gallery there, and they just love this particular artwork. So this is how my inspiration comes. And when I look at my work, it inspires me more to do more and to do more, because I think any artist, if you speak to them, you talk to them, that from where they get their inspiration, they will always say that, you know, everything inspires them. And to me, the biggest inspiration is blessings of my elders, and you know, and just the way I, you know, I am thankful that I am able to, you know, dabble with so many materials with ease. So that inspires me. I think everything is an inspiration for me.
This is
how the whole thing is.
It's really, really interesting work, you know, Neeraj. Thank you so much for taking us through this gallery. I would request you to do another gallery tour with us. We have a Hungarian artist, Judith Maria.
Yeah.
If you could take us through her work as well, you know, just a guided tour. I'm just going to enter the exhibition. She does some beautiful stonework.
And she's a beautiful person herself.
Absolutely.
Okay, so I call her Maria, and what happened was that, as I told you earlier also, that I've got a gallery in Gurgaon, and as we have the artist exchange programs, and in that artist exchange program, Maria had come to us, and she stayed with us for 15 days, and I designed her, I curated her show, designed exhibitions for her, and in that process, you know, I came really close to Maria in terms as an artist, which she is wonderful, as you said. She came to us in 2 years back. And then last year I had gone to Hungary. I stayed with her. And, you know, then once you start interacting, then you come to know more of a person, that what kind of work or what kind of person that. So she works.
Neeraj, we've lost you. Can't hear you.
And,
hello.
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. So what I was saying, that Maria says that stones, they talk to her, they speak to her, they interact with her, you know, if you see this, and she works with the stones, if you go a little closer, and she goes to the river sides, picks the stones, and now people also gift her different stones. And this is on with, she has done with the white pen. This is a sunboard thing. And look at the texture on the stone, which she converted into the artwork. And it's really, really beautiful. I mean, I have seen many artworks in the world, but the kind of energy which oozes out from her work is, I mean, it's something very different.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And then she works with wood. She combines wood and stones together, and, you know, like different materials together. And each artwork is to die for. I'm lucky to have a lot of her art with me.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, smaller works. And so she gifted us. And this is so, I mean, just look at this particular millennialistic work. Stone, yeah, just in the corner, and how profound the work is. And you can see one angel on the side.
Yes, and, absolutely. This is one of my favorite pieces of her work. Because if we go in a little closer, I'm just going to try and zoom in.
And the best is Maria is, you know, like, she's so hardworking. And, and as a person, it reflects in her work also, that how honest she is with her creations.
Absolutely. Okay.
And she's always smiling, joking, and you know, it's really wonderful.
Right.
And then she works with you know, if we look at, and artwork is not only about just to create. Art is also about how you're presenting it. You know, what kind of frames you are using. What is a combination of different things in that?
Right.
So all this is like really amazing.
Right. If we see here, she's used, you know, very raw, sort of undone wood. You know, what we call as de-stressed look.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, just to keep it earthy and very, very interesting.
Yeah.
Right.
And when she came here, she had one little portly with her, where she had picked up stones from all over the, like, wherever she travels, she picks up stones. So these were like millennialistic stones. She had it, and then she gifted this to many people. This, just pick it up, and as in, like, it's your lucky charm kind of thing.
Wow.
So once, I hope that when she comes here, and I'll make sure that we visit Chandigarh, or you visit Delhi and meet her, then you will understand more of her work and more of her, you know. So which is a real treat.
Right. Rakshita,
this is a wonderful effort by WLOC. Once again, kudos to the team, the efforts, and you all did a wonderful job by curating it so well. I know it's not easy to put paintings up on the wall like this virtually, but that's why you know, these curatorial artworks are very, very important, so that people actually learn to navigate and learn to see art and spend some time, because that's the biggest award anybody can give to any artist, that they are, their artwork is viewed properly. And in that, you have been a great support system. So thank you so much for having me as a creative director of WLOC, and today as a curator, and to have a curatorial walk with me, art walk, which we call it. So thank you so much, Akshita. It's been a wonderful journey, and I wish all the best to WLOC and to the team.
Thank you, Neeraj. Thank you so much.
Thank you.